Hey everyone, Tyler here at The Movie Beat. Welcome back to another Korean movie review. In this one, I'm going to be continuing with my underrated, under-talked about little Korean thriller series, and the last two uploads have been kind of in-depth reviews that included a lot of spoilers, so I'm going to make this one as short, as sweet, and as spoiler-free as possible, just to kind of change things up, just because people like, you know, different things out there, and I want to do something a little bit different. So today I'm going to be sharing with you guys some thoughts, basically giving you guys my recommendation to check out the 2013 Korean thriller film called Montage. A little interesting thing here with the title. The Korean title, Montage, actually means like a composite, like a forensic composite of a suspected criminal's face. So it's one of those drawings that some kind of a witness would give the police and the artist would sketch out the face. From my understanding and this use of the word montage, I have never used it that way in English, but I could be wrong, so I don't know where exactly this originally came from for the Korean usage, but they actually went with just the straight up like English version of montage, so montage. I guess it kind of works because the editing in this film, I think, is one of its key characteristics, a big takeaway, so I kind of can see that title working in that sense, but a little bit strange as a title, especially when the Korean title is, like I said, facial composite. Let's get into this review. I think you guys are going to know these actors. Uhm Jung-hwa, okay, she's definitely one of the best Korean actresses. She's in a lot of really diverse roles, thrillers, comedies, dramas, tons of stuff. So it's really awesome to see her in this one. Maybe you saw her in Okay Madam. I have a review for that and Princess Aurora, as well as Love Now that she's in. I'll put the links in the description box for you guys to check out, as well as Kim Sang-kyung. Everyone's got to know this actor from Memories of Murder. He played the detective from Seoul who came down to help out with the investigation. You might have also seen him in some Hong Sang-soo films, some of his early works, I believe, On the Occasion of Remembering the Turning Gate, as well as Tale of Cinema. I love Turning Gate, so maybe check that one out if you haven't seen it. Anyways, let's get into Montage. I'll give you guys just a real brief story outline. Again, no spoilers in this one, so enjoy some of the images that I include and sit tight. Let me give you some thoughts on Montage. 15 years ago, Yoon Hak-young's daughter, Seo-jin, was kidnapped and murdered by a man who was never found. With the statute of limitations set to expire in just 5 days, Detective Oh, who initially promised Hak-young that he'd track down the culprit no matter what and bring him to justice, visits the scene of the crime one final time to pay his respects before the case is to be closed for good. But when he discovers a memorial flower left on the ground by someone other than any known party with knowledge of the incident, a race against time begins as he utilizes nearby CCTV surveillance cams and other modern tech to find out if the person who left the flower can provide a promising lead into solving the cold case before the statute of limitations expires. Meanwhile, a new kidnapping takes place in broad daylight with the MO resembling the 15-year-old case. With Hak-young's persistence to solve her daughter's case no matter what the statute of limitations says, and nearly the entire police force dedicated to solving the new kidnapping, all parties launch an all-out effort to bring the kidnapper to justice. Now, the investigation in Montage ensues with a pretty rockin' bass-heavy soundtrack that really pumps up the tension. I personally really enjoyed the procedural and problem-solving elements in this film, both on the parts of the police and the mother Hak-young. There really aren't a lot of leaps in logic or coincidental clue drops like we often see in movies like this. Here, both the criminal and the authorities are on top of their game, which makes for the ideal battle of the wits for both parties to try and stay one step ahead long enough to achieve an outcome in their favor. Editing style is engaging as it cuts back and forth between the 15-year-old incident and the current one. Since the crime is being carried out in the exact same manner, the investigations also run parallel. So we see some of the same mistakes of the past mirrored in the present, on top of Ha-kyung and Detective Oh taking the opportunity to learn from their failed experiences in the past and to give the current investigation the edge that it needs to outsmart the evil kidnapping genius. Expect lots of heavy rain, an excellent chase sequence on the tracks outside Yongsan Station. Now, a lot of police procedural films tend to incorporate heavy expository dialogue to summarize all of the complex evidence and various findings to reinforce understanding with the audience. Personally, I do not like this storytelling technique and am quite turned off when it inevitably shows up. However, in Montage, there is very little expository dialogue to be found, and it's actually done rather cleverly through the precinct briefings and press conference rehearsals. So this was a great way to get around using this technique, and these evidence summaries actually become very entertaining with the perfectionist police captain always asking for clarification and perfect pronunciation from his officers. So great job doing that here for this film, and things really start to become interesting when Ha-kyung, the character played by Uhm Jung-hwa, her fight for justice for her daughter begins to twist into more of a mother's thirst for vengeance. And that is when this film starts kicking off, and you're in for a pretty good ride. I gotta say, in great South Korean thriller fashion, there are some excellent twists, and like I said with the title of this film, a montage, even though the Korean meaning going for that facial composite sketch of a criminal, the editing in this one is pretty awesome. So pay attention to that when you guys watch it. I'm sure things will still catch you by surprise. I think this thing ends with some pretty emotional heavy tones, which was kind of surprising. A lot of thriller movies don't really pack that punch for me. However, this is one that really does. Acting is through the roof. I gotta also mention that the actor Song Young-chang is in this film, so he is a really great sort of veteran actor that's in a lot of powerful supporting roles. So he actually plays the grandfather of the new child that is abducted, so he is a pretty cool part in this film as well. So all around, guys, check out Montage if you get a chance. It's part of my underrated, under-talked about, maybe underappreciated, I don't know, you tell me, Korean, South Korean thriller films that I want to recommend to you. So I would rate Montage a 7.5 out of 10. Extremely enjoyable. I watched mine on this single disc, non-special edition DVD edition. So it's pretty sweet. The cover here, it says 15 years ago, the guy from 15 years ago is back. Okay, he appeared, and we gotta go get him. So Montage, the title, this is our last chance. Okay, so it's pretty sweet. We got some shots here from the movie, but nothing really to write home about. No booklet, no art, no insert. I believe I actually picked this one up used at one of the an offline shop here, so I got a pretty sweet price on it. And I gotta say, I do not believe there is a Blu-ray available out there, but I was blown away by the picture quality on this DVD put out by KD Media. So it actually was very impressive considering it's DVD. And it's also worth mentioning that this was written and directed by Jung Geun-sub, who has not made any other film since this. So one thing that I love is when we get a director who also wrote the film. One thing that kind of I don't like is when we never see them return. So I hope this this filmmaker, this director, this writer gets another chance to make a film, because I love seeing work like that progress through the years and seeing them evolve. So it's always weird when a new movie comes out and it's a director that you've never heard of and they didn't write it. And I'm like, where are all those projects where we have a writer and a director? And especially when it's good and it's successful, why don't they get another chance? So I don't know a lot about this director, so maybe he's busy doing other things, but Jung Geun-sub, awesome film. Thank you so much for this one. Thanks again for tuning in, guys. Please remember to like and subscribe if you want to see more like this in the future. Share some thoughts with about this film Montage in the comments below. Have you seen it? What would you rate it? And what are some other underrated, underappreciated South Korean films that you think need more attention, that they that deserve a lot more attention that they're getting? So thanks again for watching, everybody. Until next time, I'm Tyler at The Movie Beat. Keep watching movies.